New Jersey has not elected a Republican to the United States Senate since 1972. But could things turn out differently this year? Incoming Democratic Senator Bob Menendez has been marred by a highly publicized corruption trial involving his ties to a wealthy doctor from Florida. A mistrial was eventually declared, and prosecutors declined to pursue the senator's case any further. Nevertheless, he was, quote, severely admonished, unquote, by a bipartisan Senate Ethics Committee for his actions. As we would expect, Menendez's Republican opponent, Bob Hugin, has focused on the senator's ethical issues during the course of this campaign. Recently, the anchor of State of Affairs and MetroFocus contributor, Steve Adubato, sat down with each of the candidates for a Senate race special airing on WNET and NJTV, and he joins us now. Steve, welcome back to MetroFocus.
Raf, always good to be with you and this team.
So, Steve, for those who may not know, could you give us a little information about Menendez's corruption case, what exactly it involved, and how it has affected this election.
So you mentioned the doctor. His name is Solomon Melgen. Longtime friend, 20, 30 years of Bob Menendez. Menendez said he was a friend. Here's the catch. Melgen had a doctor, an ophthalmologist, had a serious problem with federal government, Medicaid overcharging, if you will. Medicare, right? My bad. The problem is this. The federal government charged that Menendez was helping him, lobbying him, but more importantly, was taking gifts, plane trips, stays at exort hotels, if you will, and that those were gifts that Menendez was accepting from someone who he was helping. Menendez says, that's my friend. Are you kidding me? Federal government makes the case, the Department of Justice, mistrial. They decide we're not going to follow up again. But as you said, the U.S. Senate said severely admonish.
Yeah. So, you know,
he took a hit on this.
Yeah, yeah. You pressed Senator Menendez on this during your special.
That's right.
We have a clip of that. I wonder if we could take a look at it right now.
Could you understand a significant number of New Jerseyans saying, I don't know if I trust Bob Menendez?
Well, Steve, look, a couple things. First of all, as you noted, a federal judge exonerated us of the most significant charges. 11 out of 13 jurors of average New Jerseyans said we don't believe in the government's case, and several of them severely criticized the government for even bringing the case. And then a Republican Department of Justice ultimately dropped everything.
So how are our New Jersey voters responding to that defense?
You know, Raf, it's interesting. In any other year, with a president as unpopular as Donald Trump is, in a blue state like New Jersey, this should not actually be a race. It should not be that competitive. But the last Quinnipiac poll showed that Bob Menendez was only up a Democrat incumbent many, many years in there by only 6% over Bob Hugin. That's shocking.
So let's talk about Hugin. What's his background and how did he manage to get the Republican nomination?
You know, I don't want to be overly simplistic or, you know, be a wise guy about this, but I'll say this. The number is $16 million. To date, Raf, he has spent $16 million of his own money on this race.
So is he running on issues other than Menendez's ethical
Every spot, every 30-second spot, nasty, negative spot that you see from Hugin is about the trial. Bob Menendez is corrupt. People don't trust him. And the fact is, Menendez is turning around saying, wait a minute, you're the head of Celgene. This is a major pharmaceutical company. Is it not a fact that the federal government was looking at you guys and that you and your lobbyists, that Celgene spent a lot of money to keep a generic drug? I won't get into the weeds. Celgene had a very expensive cancer drug. There was a generic drug that potentially could do the same thing. The charge that Menendez is making is, are you kidding me? You and your colleagues and your lobbyists stopped that generic drug from getting in the market and stopped cancer patients from getting drugs that could have been helpful and cheaper.
New Jersey is a state where President Trump is very unpopular.
Very.
Yet, Mr. Hugin was a big supporter of Trump, and he gave him some money. He donated some money to Trump. You pursued that.
I tried.
With Mr. Hugin. We have a clip of that. Let's take a look.
Donald Trump.
Yeah.
How much money did you contribute to Donald Trump when he was running in 2016? And if you contributed that much, what did you see in him as a leader that caused you to say, yeah, he's the right person to lead our nation?
I did contribute to the Republican Party primarily was my contribution. What I saw in 2016.
But you gave to him as well.
Yes, but the majority of my contribution to the Republican Party to support the general election. What I saw in Washington in 2016 was we were stagnating, and it was not good. It needed disruption. Well, unfortunately, we now have dysfunction.
How much is this race going to be a referendum on President Trump?
Can you say stay on message? Meaning, Bob Hugin, even though he contributed, I believe the number is $4,800. You can check that out. Please. I believe it was the maximum he could contribute.
Yeah.
Yes, he gave a couple hundred grand to the Republican National Committee. The reality is the Republican National Committee was spending money to get Donald Trump elected. I'm not saying it's a crime. What I'm saying is this. In a state like New Jersey, you have to defend that. You have to defend that contribution. Bob Hugin doesn't want to talk about Donald Trump. He says things like, I disagree with him. But it is hard for Republicans to run away from Donald Trump unless they say, listen, I think he has an issue of character, integrity. He has problems with the truth. And that's why I don't believe he should be president. Other than that, you can't tiptoe around this in Jersey.
So how important is this senatorial election nationally?
To quote the president, huge. I mean, really huge. You got a 51-49 majority for the Republicans in the U.S. Senate. If this seat turns to the Republicans, that's a big deal. If Menendez holds on to it, it's a big deal.
All right, Steve. Thanks so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
We'll look at your special. And the U.S. Senate special debuts on State of Affairs with Steve Adubato on October 6th. Head on over to our website for a list of all the air dates and times.